So, I think it is very clear now. Picture is very clear. Is it not? It is very clear now. So, we have to solve the numerical or psychrometric relation. Mind it, relation. Psychrometric numericals can be solved in two ways. First one is your with the help of psychrometric chart, in which we have not to do lot of calculations. We have not to do lot of calculation from the psychrometric chart. But another way of solving the numerical is using the formulae, which are the psychrometric, which give the psychrometric relation. Here I have taken one numerical just to make you to understand how to solve in psychrometric numerical with the help of formulae, different formulas. Now the question which is given is, the reading from a sling psychrometer as follows. DBT. DBT stands for dry bulb temperature. DBT stands for dry bulb temperature. WBT. WBT stands for wet bulb temperature. Then barometric reading. Reading of the barometer. That is given 740 mm of mercury. One thing I would like to point out over here, that when you solve the question with the help of psychrometric chart, then that psychrometric chart is on 100 kilopascals, that is one bar, one atmosphere pressure. But here the pressure, or 760 of mm also, 760 of mercury also. Here it is given 740 mm of mercury. Now we have to solve it. We can use the steam table also. The use of steam table has been widely explained to you in second year. The steam engines and all that. So we have to find out using steam table, determine what? DPT. Dew point temperature. Second, relative humidity, RH. Third, specific humidity. Then fourth, degree of saturation. Five, vapor density. And sixth one, the last one, enthalpy of the mixture per kg of dry air. Enthalpy of the mixture per kg of dry air. I think it is very clear, numerical is very clear. So now we will go to the first part, solution. From the steam table, we take the steam table, saturated pressure corresponding to WBT means wet bulb temperature at 20 degree is PW, that is, it has been obtained from the steam table, and that is PW 0.2337 bar, okay, in bar it has been obtained from the steam table. We know that barometer pressure is given in the question, PB 740 mm of mercury. 740 mm of mercury. So we have to convert it into the bar. If we multiply 740 mm of mercury with 133.3, then we get 98.642 newton meter square. Okay, we get the pressure in newton meter square, and that 0.98642 bar, in the bar it would be 0.98642. okay, so it is very clear now. From the steam table we have got this value, and from pressure which was 740 bar, 740 mm of mercury, it has been converted into the bar. Now one carrier equation is there. Which equation? Carrier equation, very important equation, and one should remember this equation also for the engineering student especially. PV is equal to P PW minus PB minus PW एक ब्रैकेट में, then TD minus TW that is dry bulb temperature minus wet bulb temperature divided by 1544 minus 1.44 kilowatt, 1544 minus 1.44 kilowatt. Now we will put the values. PW value we have already find out from the steam table. PW value we have already find out from the steam table. We will put it over here. PW, then PB minus PW, that is also known, and TD minus TW, that is also known. So PW, that is your 0.02337 minus PB minus PW. PB is your, already we have calculated in bar, 0.986 minus PW. PW is your 0.02337. PW already we have calculated. We have already calculated PW. A little correction is required. We have already calculated PW from the steam table. So that value is coming to be 0.02337. The bracket mein TD minus TW, that is 30 minus 20 divided by 1544 minus 1.44 TW. 1544 minus 1.44 TW. TW value is given in the question. TW, that is 20 degree centigrade. Okay, so TD minus TW divided by TW, wet bulb temperature, dry bulb temperature DBT, wet bulb temperature WBT, both are given, and 1.544 minus 1.44 into 20. On calculation, calculating it, we get 0.01701 bar. In bar we are getting this. Now next, from the steam table we find that corresponding to the pressure of 0.017 bar, the DPT, dew point temperature, DPT stands for dew point temperature. It has been asked in the question also. See, in question first part is the DPT, dew point temperature you have to find out. So DPT from the steam table we get TDP is equal to 15 degree. This is the first part of the numerical. Okay, is it clear? We have to use over here Carrier equation. This is very important. Carrier equation you must remember. Through Carrier equation we have find out the value of PV, partial pressure of water vapor. Now from a steam table we get, it is clear now, TDP, that is dew point temperature we have got. DPT, dew point temperature. Now the second part which is telling RH, relative humidity. Normally when the weather forecast is given, always relative humidity is always announced. So from the steam table we find that saturation pressure of vapor corresponding to DBT, corresponding to dry bulb temperature. It is given over here. From sling saccharometer we have tried to find out dry bulb temperature and wet bulb temperature. So dry bulb temperature is 30 degree. So from a steam table we find that saturation pressure of vapor corresponding to DBT is 30 degree. Okay, so now PS, that is the saturation pressure which has already been find out, 0.4242, it has been already find out, divided by P, this is the PS is your 0.4242, that is equal to, divided by, phi is divided by PV upon PS. PV, from the steam table we find the saturation pressure of the vapor corresponding to DBT, this saturation pressure. From the steam table we have find out PS is equal to 0.4242 bar. Now relative humidity equation is given by PV upon PS. So that will be 0.0170 divided by 0.04242, and if you divide all these things we get 0.042, or we can say that we get the 40%. So two things have been find out. First one is your DPT, dew point temperature, DPT, and second one is RH, relative humidity, we have find out. Okay, now the third part of the numerical is specific humidity. Let us go on the next page. Specific humidity, okay, third part of the numerical is specific humidity. So specific humidity standard formula is there, you must remember that. W, in some book it is given as omega also, W is equal to 0.622 PV upon PV minus PV, 0.622 PV upon PV minus PV. This is the standard equation. Now putting all those values, we have already calculated PV, we know PV. So putting this value 0.622 into PV on the previous page, we have find out with the help of Carrier equation 0.01701, and PV, atmospheric pressure, which has been calculated in bar, 0.98642, minus PV again 0.1701. Okay, then calculating all these things, we get 0.010912 kg per kg of dry air. Kg per kg of dry air, or we can change it into, that will be 100 se multiply kare, 10.9149 per kg of dry air. Here it was kg per kg of dry air, now it is per kg of dry air. Okay, now next, number four, degree of saturation. We have to find degree of saturation, that is WS. Degree of saturation means WS. This is given by 0.0622 PS upon PB minus PS. One thing you have to take care of, that is in specific humidity at any instant it was PV upon PB minus PV. Now for the saturation the equation has been changed, and that is PB minus PS, that is PB minus PS. Putting those values 0.622 into PS, 0.04242 divided by 0.98642 PB, that is the atmospheric pressure, minus PS, saturated pressure, 0.04242. So this is the degree of saturation of the vapor, and this was a specific humidity, this is the specific humidity at saturated pressure. So calculating all these things, 0.622 into 0.4242 divided by 0.98642 minus 0.0424. Calculating all these things, we get 0.027945, that is kg per kg of dry air. So this is the specific humidity at the saturated portion, and this is the specific humidity at any instant. So the degree of saturation mu, which is given by W upon WS. W we have calculated earlier, W, that is 0.10914, and at saturated pressure the value comes out to be 0.2794. So the ratio of the two, that is degree of saturation given by W upon WS, and that is 0.0 10914 divided by 0.027945, and that gives 39.391, or in percentage if we take, then it is 39%. So the fourth part has been solved. Degree of saturation as per the numerical requirement, mu, that is 39.1%. Okay, we can calculate this degree of saturation by another way also. Another formula is there, PV upon PS, bracket may PV minus PS divided by PV minus PV. Another formula also available for the calculation of degree of saturation, and that is given by PV upon PS 0.01701 divided by 0.04242 multiplied by PV minus PS 0.98642 minus 0.04242 divided by 0.98642 minus 0.01701. So from here also if we calculate the value of degree of saturation, then it will be the same value, 0.391, or 39.1%. You see, the previous calculation also gave 39.1%, and the latter calculation also gave 39.1%. So the meaning is that we can calculate the degree of saturation by two ways. Firstly, using the formula mu is equal to W upon WS, which gives you directly 39.1%, and another formula, PV upon PS, PV minus PS divided by PV minus PV, and that gives also 39.1%. So you can use either of the formula. You can use either of the formula in the examination. Now let us come on the fifth part. That is, fifth part is your vapor density. What is that? Vapor density, which is given by rho V. Vapor density is given by rho V. So rho V is equal to W PV minus PV divided by RA into TD. These are the standard formula. You have to remember all these formulas. So rho V is equal to W into PV minus PV divided by RA into TD. That is equal to W, we already know, that is 0.010914 into bracket mein PB, that is the atmospheric pressure, 0.98642 minus PV 0.01701, and then you multiply it by 10 to the power 5 to change it into the Newton per meter square. RA is the standard gas constant, it is the gas constant, which is given by 287 multiplied by 273 plus 30. 30 degrees is the dry bulb temperature. It has been converted into Kelvin. Here it has been converted into Kelvin. So calculating all these value, 0.010914, bracket mein 0.98642 minus 0.01701 divided by 287, bracket mein 273 plus 30, Kelvin mein change kiya, into 10 to the power 5. इसको न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर में चेंज किया, सो वी गेट द वैल्यू 0.01216 केजी पर मीटर क्यूब ऑफ ड्राई एयर, केजी पर मीटर क्यूब ऑफ ड्राई एयर, माइंड इट, ओके। सो वेपर डेंसिटी वी कैन डायरेक्टली कैलकुलेट इट बिकॉज वी हैव गॉट द फॉर्मूला फॉर दैट, एंड वी कैन डायरेक्टली कैलकुलेट द वेपर डेंसिटी यूजिंग द फार्मूला W into PV minus PV divided by RA into TD. RA is your gas constant. It has got the standard value 287. So in that way, we have calculated the vapor density also. Now the next part and the last part, which has been asked in the numerical, let us see on the previous page. It has been asked in the numerical. Enthalpy of the mixture per kg of dry air. Last part, sixth part, enthalpy. We have to calculate the enthalpy of the mixture per kg of dry air. So, for that enthalpy of the mixture, per kg of dry air. So from the steam table, we are again using the steam table. From the steam table, we find that the latent heat of vaporization of water at DPT, dew point temperature 15 degree centigrade, is given by HFGDP. HFG stand for latent heat, that is from liquid to gas, DP, that temperature, and we get it from the steam table, and that value is 2466.1 kg per kg, kg per kg of dry air. So this is the value of the latent heat of vaporization. Now, standard formula we know for the calculation of enthalpy. Enthalpy of a mixture per kg of dry air is given by H is equal to enthalpy is equal to 1.022 TD. 1.022 TD. This is specific heat. This is your humid specific heat. 1.022. This is called humid specific heat. TD plus W. W is your degree of saturation. W is your degree of saturation into HFGDP. HFGDP, which you have seen from the steam table, plus 2.3 TDP. Putting the values, H is equal to 1.022 TD, that is dry bulb temperature, already known 30 degree, plus W into 0.10914. This value is already known. So W is already known. W we have already calculated above. You can see it. We have already calculated W here. We have calculated 0. In the starting we have calculated 0.010914, and we will put that value over here. 0.010914, and HFGDP that we have already taken from the steam table, that is 2466.1 plus 2.3 into 15. Putting all these values, we can calculate it, and we get the value of enthalpy, and that is equal to 57.95 kilojoule per kg of dry air. Calculating all this value, we get the enthalpy. So in that way, we have find out all the five things which has been asked in the numerical, and given was your DTP, dry bulb temperature, wet bulb temperature, and barometric pressure. So DTP, first we dew point temperature, we have calculated it, dew point temperature, then RH we have calculated it with the help of relative humidity, we have calculated, then third part, specific humidity we have calculated, W, and then degree of saturation we have calculated mu in two ways, and another value mu in another two ways. There are two ways to calculate the value of degree of saturation. We have calculated it separately, and both the values giving the same result. Then vapor pressure, vapor density, rho v, that we have calculated with the help of formula. Rho v has got a standard formula, and we get 0.1216 kg per meter cube of the dry air. Okay, then we calculated the enthalpy formula, 1.022 TD plus W into HFGDP plus 2.3 into DP. This 1.022 is humid specific heat. This is called humid specific heat. Now putting these values, we have calculated the value of enthalpy, 1.022 into 30 plus 0.010914 W into HFGDP plus 2.3 into TDP, that is dew point temperature, and we get 57.95 kg per kg of dry air. In that way, we have calculated all the six values. And one thing very important which I would like to tell, that normally new questions are asked in numerical form without using the psychrometric chart. So this was one of the numerical without using the psychrometric chart, and this was the important numerical. So thank you for listening to me. If you like the video, please press your button. Okay, thank you.